Okay, so it seems that Anthropic have been pushing updates like crazy to Claude Code because we have yet another big update. Meanwhile, the OpenAI Codex team have been taking a nap because we haven't seen something particularly interesting or a big update for the last few weeks. But anyways, we're going to be going through this update to Claude Code, which includes Claude Code Web and also a brand new sandbox mode as well. Now, firstly, with Claude Code Web, you can now run Claude Code on the Claude.ai website, and that probably kills a bunch of the startups that were doing like Claude Code but running online. And you can also run it on the iOS application as well. It's unfortunately not available on the Android application yet, and I guess that's a life of being an Android user. But hey, so if you go to Claude.ai, then you can press the code button, and that should take you to a brand new Claude.ai/code. And then during the onboarding, you link it up with your GitHub account, and then you choose your default Claude Code environment. And this is basically for safety when it comes to coding. And the recommended option is trusted network access, which means that there's some kind of like whitelist of domains that are only allowed when it comes to running Claude Code in the cloud. And if you click this link down here, then you can see the list of trusted websites that they have. And this includes some like container registries, GitHub, package managers, and so forth. Anyways, let's click on trusted network access. And then we can pick one of our repositories. So I'm going to pick the repository for my text-to-speech application, which is HyperWhisper. There will be a coupon code down below for this. So basically, search for HyperWhisper. And then I can add a different environment as well. So I can choose another environment that has no network access or a custom access with like allowed domains that can only be accessed. So this can be particularly good for like enterprises which only want to access internal documentations or something like that. And then you can also set your environment variable keys, because in some cases you may have an environment where you have a build command that has to run, and that checks if your environment keys are there or not. And if they're not there, then the build command fails, and Claude Code can basically run build commands better because you put in your environment variables into here. Anyways, what I want to try doing with Claude Code Web now is translate the entire landing page of the application into Japanese. I recently translated this Swift UI application to Japanese because I saw that I was getting purchases from Japan randomly. So I figured like I might as well get more purchases from Japan by having it in Japanese. Hey, so can you translate the landing page of the Next.js application to Japanese, come up with the key value pairs, and install the relevant packages? First, come up with a plan and then let me know what you're going to be doing, and if I approve, then go ahead and do it. So if I press enter, then there's an option that says enable notifications. I can enable that, and then Claude Code will then notify me like, hey, when this is done. And now you can see it's running right over here, and it seems that when it gets to a point when it stops, then I will be able to open this up in the CLI or create a brand new PR for this. And you can see it's created its own branch here, which is add a Japanese translation. If I open up iPhone mirroring, then I can go to Claude app, and I should be able to see the exact same thing. So going to code, I can then click on the session, and I can see that this is in progress. And I can also enable notifications on my phone as well, allow, and then I will be known or like notified when this is done. So this is a plan that I came up with, and if I say go for it, then it gives me a to-do list, kind of like the one that you see on the CLI. So I like how they're going for the same feel, where they have crunching, moseying, unraveling, and so forth. So yeah, it feels very familiar in a way. Now, I think that Claude Code Web, just like Codex CLI Web, is significantly better for tasks that require only one or two things, like very small changes, in the sense that you don't require as much back and forth. When there's a lot of back and forth, it's better to use it in a CLI or use it in VS Code or something instead with the IDE extension. But when there is a very well-defined task, such as translating a web page, then it's much better to have it running in the cloud, and then you can focus on bigger tasks in the CLI version instead. Anyways, whilst we're waiting for this to complete, let's go through the brand new sandbox mode that they have available. Hey, so as a short aside, after popular demand, I made a brand new Claude Code class that's available. There will be a link down below, and I basically cover every single Claude Code feature that's available, and I'm continuing to update the class every time a brand new feature comes out. So it can be pretty useful for you if you want to master everything to do with Claude Code, or if you want to train your entire company up in using Claude Code. Everything is covered in this class, including many of the advanced features. So if you do want to take your Claude Code skills to the next level, do check it out. There will be a link down below. Now, they did write a blog post about this, and they wrote some docs about this as well, so I'll quickly be going through that. Now, firstly, if you've used a Claude Code CLI before, then you know that it asks for permissions quite a lot, and this can get quite annoying over time because you're always pressing approve, 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 And eventually it becomes quite dangerous because some people get tired of approving stuff, so they disapprove everything. And then you're more at risk of a prompt injection or something, especially if Claude Code is finding things online or decides to edit a file outside of the workspace you're currently in. And then maybe Claude Code comes across a prompt injection online in a repo, it downloads some like software on your computer, and then all your crypto is gone or whatever. So what they introduced is a sandboxing mode, and I'll show you how to enable it shortly. Basically creates predefined boundaries in which Claude Code can work freely instead of having to ask for permission every time. And this includes file system isolation, which ensures Claude Code can only access and modify specific directories, and also network isolation, which means that Claude can only connect to approved servers. And like I said earlier, this can prevent a prompt injector Claude from leaking sensitive information or downloading malware. So basically what they introduced is a brand new sandboxing runtime, of which the docs are available here and will be going through shortly. And they also made the same runtime that it uses open source. So you can see it's available here. If you download it, then you can also use it in other circumstances, such as if you replace a npx command for an MCP server with SRT instead, then it will sandbox that particular server, meaning that an MCP server that you have running locally, such as in Claude Desktop, can only run like within a certain folder or only access certain websites. And they do explain more how this actually works, but we won't be going through that part in this video. And then there's some example configuration for the sandbox as well. And there's some more information and diagrams on how it works. And this is exactly what the web version of Claude Code is running. And now we can enable it on our own version. Anyways, firstly, we want to make sure we're on the latest version of Claude by doing Claude update. And then by running Claude Code, we can then see we have a new slash command, which is slash sandbox. So running slash sandbox, we can see that we can then configure it. Right now it's disabled, so pressing enter. So you can see we have a couple options here. We have no sandbox, sandbox bash tool with auto allow and accept edits mode, and sandbox with regular permissions. And then we can define more specific permissions. So let's first go to with regular permissions, press enter. And then if we open up the Claude settings JSON file, we can see currently it looks kind of like this. So you can see that we have sandbox enabled and we have auto allow bash if sandbox set to false. And that basically means that it will not auto approve bash commands when sandboxed. There are a couple of properties here, such as excluded commands. Commands that can run outside the sandbox, such as Docker, you would still want your Docker server that you have running locally to start and whatnot. And then you can set up your own proxies as well, instead of having Claude use their own proxies. And this can be quite useful if you have like a corporate proxy and you want to inspect everything that's actually passing through somehow. Okay, so in my case, I'm going to add these to excluded commands because I want to be able to run Git and Docker from Claude Code within the sandbox. So if I then go to sandbox here, paste this in, exclude commands, also add Git. And the next thing I want to do is also add local binding, because currently with background bashes, if I try and run npm run dev via Claude Code, then it will fail because right now it's off. The default is off for allowing binding to local pods. So you can see right now, if I tell Claude Code to do npm run dev in the next.js folder, then after finding that particular folder, it will then say sandbox blocked one operation, use slash sandbox to disable the sandbox. And I don't want to disable the sandbox, but I still want to be able to run npm run dev. So what I can do is I can basically copy over this network part, allow local binding, paste that into here. And this basically means that allow local binding will be able to see any Docker containers that I have running. And as for allow Unix sockets, it means that it will be able to connect to Docker and like see anything happening in my Docker containers. Anyway, so if I close Claude Code, we started to apply those settings again, and then say npm run dev in the next.js folder, then you can see it ran completely fine, just as you would expect. Anyway, so you can use these sandboxing settings to basically set up like good permissions and best practices for your organization, especially when you're using Claude Code, and then have them synced across everyone's repos, because it's in the settings.local.json file. And as for the other changes since my last video, we now have a brand new toggle to enable and disable thinking in the IDE. So if you use something like VS Code and you have the Claude Code like extension installed, on the right-hand side, you can see there's a stopwatch kind of icon. And this basically enables and disables thinking mode when it comes to the Claude Code VS Code extension. And finally, we have two more changes here. Claude Code will now ask you more questions in planning mode more often, and there's now an interactive question mode. So I can say something like, using the interactive question tool, can you give me a quiz? It should be a math quiz with 5 different questions. So it seems to be generating the quiz with that tool, but it seems the tool only allows up to 4 questions at a time, unfortunately. And for some reason, in this particular case, it decides to give me the answers, but I'm just going to do something ridiculous. So you can type something else, which is quite ideal. say 200. And you can see this is a feedback that it gave me. So unfortunately, I only got 50%. But the power of this tool actually comes in when you're prompting it. So in your claude.md file, for example, or your skills file, you may tell Claude Code, hey, can you use an interactive quiz tool to basically ask me any more clarifying questions before getting started with X, Y, or Z? Claude Code will, by default, use this tool more often in the planning mode. So if in planning mode, I say something like, can you change the color scheme of the landing page? Then after exploring the project, you can see it will then ask me some clarifying questions about the color scheme that I would like. So it gave me some pretty good questions here about the theme style. I can also go here, background, accent style, and it seems it gave me three questions here. So I think this tool is pretty powerful. Like Claude Code does tend to be more forgiving when your plans are not very good, which is especially good for like new developers. But I think one small disadvantage is this tool only allows for up to four questions, unfortunately. And when you're getting started with a brand new project, Claude Code may need to ask you like 20 questions or so forth in planning mode. So you may have to tell Claude Code, don't use an interactive quiz tool, ask me like 20, 30 questions instead, just as they are. And then you can use a tool like Hyperwhisper to quickly answer all those questions. Okay, so now if we go back to programming task for translating landing page from earlier on in the video, you can see I can either create a PR out of this. I can't actually see the code that it changed, unfortunately. So I think this web version still needs a tiny bit of work. Because the Codex CLI version allows you to see like inline diffs and so forth. So I can either create a PR out of this, and then you can see it's right over here. I can see the diffs that I made. And if I press open in CLI, then it will copy a command to my clipboard, so I can hand off this entire chat history to my local version of Claude Code. So if I paste in this command, you can see it says Claude teleport, then the session ID, press enter. Then it will, because it's connected to the same account, it will then load up the Claude Code project. But I have to clear my Git working directories, so give me a second. And now if I run that command again, you can see this entire session and the session history has been loaded onto my computer. So I can then continue the session as it is. And I think that's like a pretty handy, powerful tool. And you can see, because in this case, after resuming the session, the context window is about 50%. It means basically everything like token-wise has been loaded back into this session of Claude Code. Anyways, those are basically all the updates for Claude Code today. If you do want to check out the Claude Code class that I have that covers basically everything to do with Claude Code, then it will be linked down below with a coupon code.